My name is Mara Cactons. I'm an archaeologist here at Ferry Farm. Specifically, I am the ceramics and glass expert, which means that it's my job to analyze the excavated ceramics and glass sherds that come into our lab. Probably one of the most interesting findings that we've come across during the ceramic analysis has been glue residues on Mary Washington's ceramics. The first vessel that we identified glue on was this punch bowl here in front of me. It's a creamware punch bowl, hand-painted, and it was probably broken into at least four pieces before it was mended together. We've been doing some analysis on the glues as well as some experimental archaeology to determine what glue Mary might have used. The chemical analysis so far has indicated that her glue had a high percentage of calcium carbonate in it, as well as some kind of animal protein. It was an organic glue. It either contained hide or cheese. So today we are going to make a cheese glue for you, and we've got the modern day equivalents of the ingredients for a cheese glue. Egg whites. This is calcium carbonate powder, which we know was present in Mary's glues. This acts as a hardener. And then we also have casein, which is milk protein. So first I'm gonna get the two powders blended up. And make no mistake, this is going to be ugly and chunky and smelly, but science is sometimes smelly. So we're going to add the egg whites. Here we have the finished product, the cheese glue. I'm going to take these two pieces of ceramic and mend them with the glue. And like I said, we have to do this very quickly because it will set up. And we learned this through trial and error. See, experimental archaeology. Okay, so you just need a little bit on there. And I'm just gonna hold this for a minute or two and let it set up. So it's been about 5 minutes and we have our sherds here that we glued together. And as you can see, success. Okay, so what did we learn from all of these glue experiments? Well, we reproduced probably half a dozen different glues from period recipes. What we were able to determine from that was that none of the glues resulted in a viable vessel after mending. So this means that Mary was having these ceramics mended so that the resulting vessels would be ornamental, used as decoration. She would not have been able to use them to eat or drink out of any longer. So what this means about Mary ultimately is that she was a fairly frugal woman and understood the value of an object, even if it was repaired. Even though she couldn't utilize it for its intended purpose, it still had value as an ornamental object that people could see in her home.